Hello everyone, welcome to IACE. Today discuss about SSC contrapted quiz. Let's go for the questions. Let's check the first question. We have a 30 second time. Start the timer. The question is belongs to speed, time and distance. The question is asked in SSC MTS in 2019 year. It is a very easy. Once you focus the question is very easy. 3, 2, 1, the timer off. Yes. Look at the question. Here is required average speed. How to calculate average speed? Total distance by total time. Total distance by total time is first to 15 kilometers. Then first 15 kilometers is going by 13 kmph, means it takes how many hours? Half an hour. Plus next to 25 kilometers. Next to 25 kilometers, 10 kmph means it will take how many hours? 2.5 hours. 2.5 hours. Then total distance by total time apply, you will get average speed. 15 plus 25 is equal to 40, and 0.5 plus 2.5 is equal to 3. 40 by 3 kmph. Then option A is correct. Okay. Let's go for the next question. Let's start the timer. Interest based question. Try to solve it. The question is asked in 2018 CHSL exam. Three, two, one, zero. Time up. The simple interest on a certain sum for 3.5 years at 10% per annum is 2940. Okay, 3.5 years. 3.5 years you can write 7/2. 7/2 years, 10% rate of interest. Nothing but it will be get how much percentage? 35% rate of interest. 35% purpose you will get 2940 rupees interest. For the same sum, you have to wait for how many years? 2.5 years. At same rate of interest. Same rate of interest means how much percentage? 10%. Okay. Then here first year 10%, second year 10% means the net percentage change becomes 21% as per the compound interest. This is for 2 years. This is for how many years? 2 years, but extra we have to wait for half an hour extra. Half year extra, not half an hour, half year extra. Half year extra means for half year purpose you have to calculate 5%. Then first 2 years value 21, and you have to apply the net percentage change formula. 2.5 years, first 2 years, next half year, and 21 into 5 by 100. 21 plus 5 value 26. 21 5 the value is 105. 105 by 100 value 1.05. it is value is 27.05. Here 27.05 interest value is how much? This is we have to calculate. Cancel the measurements here. So 7 5 and next 7 4 is 28, 7 2 and 0. That means 35% is equal to 2940. 5% value is how much rupees? 420. And 5% value is 420 means here 20% value is how much? Because I need 27%. First of all, I need to calculate 20% at least. So 5 to 24 times 4, 4 is 16, 4 to the 8, it is equal to 1680. And extra I need 7%. 5% value. 5% value is 420. Okay. So 1600, 400, it is a 2018, 20, it is a till now, it is a 2100 up to 25%. Extra 2% required. 5% value is 420 means 10% value is 840, and 1% value is 84, and 2% value is 168. That means 8, and it is a 16, and 16 it is a 22. 2268, and extra we required 0.5% also. Okay, 0.5%. 5% 420 means 0.5% value is 4 rupees. Then 4 rupees is added to 2268, you will get 2272. Then final answer is 2272. Otherwise, 2268 is also very near to 2272. Option A is correct. Some calculation is more, but it is required for it is. Let's check the next question. Start the timer. It is an income based question. So try to view the answers. Income is equal to expenditure plus savings. That is a basic rule for us. Yeah, time up. Look at. Here, incomes ratio is 2 is to 3, A and B, and their expenditure ratio is 1 is to 2, and there is a condition, 90% of B's expenditure is equals to the income of A. Here 90% you can write 90 by 100, 90% of B expenditure is equal to income of A, then B by A is equals to what is the value, you can write 10 by 9, B's expenditure is equal to A's income. This is A's income and B's expenditure here. Okay. B A's income and B expenditure. Okay. Here A income is, here is 2 rupees given, but here is we have to take 9 rupees. Then simply I am multiplying 2 here. It is values 20 by 18. This ratio also you have to change it. Okay. Now coming to the point, A and B income value. Income value what I am writing? Here I am totally multiplying with 9. 9 2s are 9 3s are. A income is 18 rupees means B income is 27 rupees. In this we have to remove expenditure. B expenditure is 20 rupees. B expenditure is 20 rupees. And coming to the B value is 20 rupees means A value is 10 rupees. Because comparing to B value, A value is off. Here is 10 rupees. Now we can write savings from income. Expenditure is removed, the result is belongs savings, then 8 rupees savings and 7 rupees savings. Then savings ratio is what is the ratio? 8 is to 7. 8 is to 7 means option C is correct. Let's check the next question. Start the timer. It is a simple interest based question. I hope everyone can do this. Mostly who knows the concept of simple interest. Three, two, one. Time up. Look at the simple interest on a sum is equal to the sum itself. Your investment is 100 rupees. And for x years, x rate of interest, then PTR by 100 is equal to you are getting a 100 rupees interest. Whatever the principal investment, it is equal to interest. Okay. And time and rate of interest both are same. Here is x years, x. Here 100 cancel. X square is equal to 100 means x is equal to how much? 10. Your rate of interest is 10%, time is 10 years. Okay. Rate of interest is 10%, time is 10 years. Numerically, both are equal. Then, how many number of years? Option B. 10 years is the correct. Let's check the next question. The next question, timer start. It is a percentage based question. टाइमर आप। देर आर 90 स्टूडेंट्स इन ए क्लास आउट ऑफ विच 70% आर फ्रॉम विलेज ए एंड अदर्स आर फ्रॉम विलेज बी, विलेज ए एंड विलेज बी। सो आई एम इग्नोरिंग दिस 90 स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टेकिंग 70 मेंबर्स हियर। हियर इज 70 मेंबर्स, हियर इज 30 मेंबर्स, टोटली हाउ मेनी मेंबर्स? 100 मेंबर्स। ओके, 70 मेंबर्स एवरेज इज वॉट एंड दैट इज बिलोंग्स टू ए विलेज एंड 30 मेंबर्स एवरेज इज वॉट that is equal to overall average. Okay, the average score of students from village A in a test is 20% more. Here 100% means here is 120%, here is 5x means here is 6x. The number of students into average, number of students into average you can multiply, you will get total value. The total value by total number of students, you will get total average also. The total average is 53. We have to solve this. Here is 0, 0, 0 will be cancelled. 7, 5 is 35, 6, 3 is 18. 35 plus 18 is equals to 53x by 10 is equals to 53. 53, 53 cancel. X is equal to values 10. Then what is the average score of the students from village B? Village B is 6x. 6 into 10 is equal to what is the value? 60. 60 means which option is correct? Option B is correct. Let's check the next question. Timer start. This question is asked in SSC MTS in 2019. Pipe and system based. The topic is pipe and system. I hope everyone can understand the session. 10, time up. Look at, A can fill a tank in 6 hours, B can fill a tank in 8 hours, all together. All together means A plus B plus C. All together can fill a tank in how many hours? 12 hours. LCM value is 24. 6 4s are 8, 3s are 12, 2s are. You can observe that all together is working means the efficiency should be more. But the efficiency is very less, then AB value is efficiency value 7. AB efficiency is 7, then C efficiency is minus 5, that's why the total efficiency is become 2. So under efficiency 2 ayindi ante andulo A value B value total add chestene manaku 7 vachinappudu, then C efficiency em avutundi? Minus 5, ante C anedi em chestundi? Water ni release chestundi, fill cheyaledu release chestundi ante empty chestundi. So the question is, then which of the following statement is true for pipe C? ఈ 24 లీటర్స్ ని ఎంటీ చేయడానికి ఎంత టైం పడుతుంది? ఓకే, సో హియర్ దెన్ 24/5 ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ 4.8 అవర్స్. 4.8 అవర్స్ మీన్స్ 4 అవర్స్ ప్లస్ 8.8 అవర్స్. 0.8 అవర్స్ మీన్స్ 6 ఏజ్ మీన్స్ 48 మినిట్స్. దెన్ విచ్ ఆప్షన్ ఇస్ కరెక్ట్? ఆప్షన్ సి ఈజ్ కరెక్ట్. అండ్ బోత్ ఆర్ క్యాన్సల్ బికాస్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో ఫిల్లింగ్ ఛాన్స్, ఓన్లీ ఎంటీయింగ్ ఛాన్స్. అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఆన్సర్ ఇస్ ఆప్షన్ సి ఈజ్ కరెక్ట్. లెట్స్ గో ఫర్ ద నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్. The timer start. The question is based on the income expenditure savings. Maximum use your time to solve the questions. It is very helpful to crack the exams also. 3, 2, 1. Time up. The ratio of monthly income of Pavan and Sunil is 4:3 and the ratio of their monthly expenditure is 3:2. If Pavan and Sunil saves 4000 and 6000 respectively per month, then what is the sum of their monthly income? Sum of their monthly income is 4 parts and 3 parts is what? 4 plus 3 is equals to how many parts? 4 plus 3 is equal to 7 parts. Then sum of their monthly incomes also belongs to 7 multiples. Then which option is 7 multiples? No option is 7 multiples, only except B. Only option B is the 7 multiples, then answer is option B is. Okay, this is a way also you can solve the question. It's very easy. Otherwise, if you need the particularly simplification, means we can do that. Okay, their incomes ratio is 4:3 and their expenditure ratio is 3:2 and first person saving is 4000, second person saving is 6000. Okay, this is we can write. This is income, this is expenditure and savings. How to solve? Here 4, 2 you can multiply, 3 into 3 you can multiply. 4 2 is 8, 3 3 is 9. 9 parts to 8 parts, how many parts difference? 1 part difference. It is gives rise to, again now, 3 6 is 18,000, 4 2 is 8,000. 18,000 to 8,000 difference is how many thousand? 10,000. 1 part is equals to 10,000. I need to know total incomes. Total incomes. Total incomes means first person income is 4 parts, second person is income is 3 parts. Total is how many parts? 7 parts. 1 part is equal to 10,000 means then 7 parts is equal to how many thousand? 70,000. This is the way we can solve the question by the simplification. But before that also, only one option is available, multiples of 7, that is also you can decide it. Let's go for the next question. Start the timer. So it is a percentage based question. The question is asked in CHSL 2018. Three, two, one. Time up. Yes, there are four candidates: A, B, C, D. And E also, sorry, it is a fifth candidate. E have a 100 rupees, assume it. D is 20% more, means D value is 120. And C is 60% less, comparing to D value, C value 60% less. Then 50% value 60 rupees, 10% value 12 rupees. 60 plus 12 means 72 rupees we have to remove from the D to get C value. Then 72 remove it, you will get 48 rupees. 70 plus 40 is 110 and 8 plus 210 overall is 120. Okay, C value got. Then B is 25% more than C. Comparing to C, B value is 25% more. 25% value is 1 by 4th. 1 by 4th of 48 value is 12. 12 extra. Okay, comparing to C, B have. Then 12 extra means B salary is become how much rupees? 60 rupees. Now A value. A is 20% more. Then 10% value 6 rupees means 20% means 12 rupees more. Then 12 rupees is adding to B value to get A value. It is a value is how much rupees? 72 rupees. Now every person value is available. Now look at the first option. Then we have to decide the options. D is 60% less than B. Basically D is more than B, not less than B. That means first option is wrong. E is 28% more than A. Then E is 100. 100 is more than A, but not 28%. Okay, 28 rupees more, but not 28%. This option is wrong. And A is 40% less than D. A is less than D, basically. Yes, A to D, how much rupees less? 48 rupees less, comparing to here D value. A is comparing to D value. That's why we are writing denominator is D. And I need percentage multiply with 100. 0, 0 will be cancelled. 12 to 48, 4 times. It is a how much percentage less? 40% is this. The line is very true, then option C is correct. Let's go for the next question. Start the timer. You have a 45 seconds to solve this question. First of all, understand the question, you can easily solve it. Thank you. If you have an idea about divisibility rules, the question is easy. This question asked in 2018 CHSL exam. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, time up. Yeah, look it. There is a number 342X18YR. These are the numbers that we have to focus. And what was the numbers? And it is divisible by 72. Any number is divisible by 72 means it is also divisible by 8 and 9. Okay. And what is the divisibility rule of 8? Last 3 digits should be divisible. Last 3 digits are what? 8Y6. And they clearly mention Y value should be largest. Y value will be largest means you can write it what? Y value I am substituting 9. Why? Because 896 is clearly divisible by 8. Then you will get remainder is what? 0. 8 ones are 8 twelves are. Okay. That means you have to substitute largest value means then Y suitable largest number is 9. More than 9 single digit largest number we don't have that. Then it is solved. Now we have to focus X. Then now I am not going to divisibility rule of 8. I am going to divisibility rule of 9. What is the divisibility rule of 9? Sum of all the digits should be divisible by 9. Then total number can be divisible by 9. Clear? Then look at 3 plus 4 7, 7 plus 2 is 9, 9 plus 1 10, 10 plus 8 18, 18 plus 9 is 27, 27 plus 6 is equal to 33. The sum of the digits values 33 plus x. Y value already substituted, granted I am taking 9. Then 33 plus x, x value, what is the value to substitute to divisible by 9 and to getting a remainder is 0. Okay, then 9 multiples I need. More than 33, near to 33, 9 multiples means the number is 36. I need 36 means 33 plus x value. What is the value we have to substitute? 3 value we have to substitute. That means now x value is 3, y value 9. Of course, now you got the values. The question is root of 9x plus y. Then x value is 3, y value is 9. 9 threes are 27, 27 plus 9, 27 plus 9 value is root of 36. Root of 36 answer is what? 6. Option D is correct. Clear? Let's go for the next question. Start the timer. You have a 25 seconds time because it is very easy. The question is asked in 2019 MTS exam. It is a profit and loss based question. I hope everyone answer it. Time up. The selling price of an article is 8 by 7 of cost price. Cost price is 7 rupees, selling price is 8 rupees. Okay. SP is equal to 8 by 7 of CP. Then CP will be coming to here. Then it is a value is 8 by 7. That's why I said selling price is 8 rupees, cost price is 7 rupees. Every 7 rupees, 1 rupee is a profit means then what is the percentage of profit? 100 by 7, you can write 14 2 by 7 percentage profit also, but not required the clarity about that. Simply we know that 100 by 7 is percentage profit. Then option D is correct. Let's go for the next question. Start the timer. Basic simplification question. We have to use V-Bodmer rules. There is no larger number. All are smaller numbers, but the confusing is how to apply the V-Bodmer. That is the only question is. The question is asked in 2018 CGL exam. One, zero. Time up. So we'll solve it. Look at, we have to give as per the V-Bodmer rule, we have to give the importance to half. After that, you can come into the division. Okay. So 2 into 3 divided by 2 threes are 6 into 2 division. एंड 4 प्लस 4 इंटू 4 डिवाइडेड बाई 4 ऑफ 4 वैल्यू 16 -4 डिवाइडेड बाई 4 इंटू 4। दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन। नाउ कमिंग टू द ब्रैकेट साइड, 4 प्लस 4 इंटू 4 बाई 16 -4 डिवाइडेड बाई 4 इंटू 4। ओके, 4 4 जा 16, 4 प्लस 1, here 4 4 cancel, it is a 1. 1 into 4 value is 4, this is a minus 4 and plus 4 will be cancelled, this is a result value is 1 only, 1 will be left inside the bracket. And division, 2 into 3 by 6 into 2, 2 3 is 6, it is a overall value is 2, 2 division by 1, 2 divided by 1 answer is what, 2 only, 2 means option B is correct. Let's go for the next question. Start the timer. It is a time, speed, and distance question. The question is asked in 2018 CCL. It is one of the important questions. Yeah, time up. Look at here, you have a 384 kilometers certain distance, same 384 kilometer distance. If the speed is reduced to 16 km/h, okay, your speed is s, now speed is reduced by 16 km/h, then here to here the time is how many hours more? 2 hours more. When the speed is s, your speed is more. When speed is s minus 16, your speed is less. Then speed is less, then you will take more time. More time minus less time difference is what? 2 hours. Okay, 2 hours more to cover the same distance. What is the 75% of original speed here? Okay, if you are going to solving this question, you will get quadratic equation. Instead of the quadrification, you have to go with, so 75% means 3 by 4. Okay, they are mentioned 3 parts of the speeds. Okay, then 3 multiples you can consider. It is a not 3 multiples. Okay, now you can go with the options. 3 parts. 3 parts is equal to 42. Then 3 14s are. 14 4s are 56. 56 substitute here. Then as per the B option, 384 by 40 minus 384 by 56. 4 10s are. 4 9s are 36 and 4 6s are. And 4 1s are. 4 4s are. 4 9s are 36 and 6. And it is 7 is not multiple, that means not equal to 2 you will get, that means B option is wrong. And go with the C option. 3 parts is equal to 45, 1 part is equal to 15, 15, 15 for the 60, original speed is 60. Then 384 by 60 minus 16 means 44 minus 384 by here 60. Okay, here then 11 multiples you will get. 96 by 11 you will get a decimal, that means option C is also wrong because the option is belongs to exactly 2 hours. Now going to option D, then only one option is left to D, then try to solve it. 384, here 3 parts is equal to 48 means 1 part is equal to 12, 4 parts is equal to here, then 3 part it is a 16, 16 4 is 64, it is a 64, it is a 64, 64 minus 16, 64 minus 16 minus 384 by 16, 64. Here 4, otherwise cancel with 8. 8 4 za is 32, 8 6 za is 8, 8 za is 64, and 8 8 za, and 8 6 za, and 64 minus 16, 64 minus 14 is a 50, it is a 48. 48 to 384, 8 times, 8 minus 6 is equal to 2 hours, only one option is clear, option D is a clear. Of course it takes some more time, but if you are solving this equation, it takes more time. Instead of that, go through the options are better for us. Okay, so option D is correct finally. Let's go for the next question. Let's go for the next question. Start the timer. The question is belongs to time and work based. So it is an easy one. I hope everyone can do this. Who knows the concept of time and work? This question is asked in CGL 2018. So take your time and try to solve it. We need maximum answers your side. Keep trying. Three, two, one, time up. Yeah, let's start the question. ABC efficiency ratio is 2:5:3, and working together, all of three of them can complete the work in 27 days. Then 2 units, 5 units, 3 units, total is 10 units. 10 units they are working in 27 days means total work is how many units? 270 units. This 270 units we are going to giving to the work for whom? B and C only. B and C, they means their efficiency is how much? 8. This total work by efficiency means you will get time. But I don't need the total work. I need 4/9 part. Okay. Just to 4/9 part as per this question. Then we'll get an answer clearly. 4 how many times? 2 times, 2 to 10, 5 times, and 9 to 27, 3 times. 5 3 is equal to how many days are required? 15 days are required. 15 days means option A is correct.